voluminous makes them really, they have a lot of volume. Hi guys, it's Alana. Welcome back. Today I'm going to do a get ready with me video. No one has asked for this, but my hair. I'm literally Medusa. I felt like doing it, so we're gonna do it. First, I pull up my hair because that ain't gonna work. I look like a little toddler. First thing I do is I just clean my face with some micellar water. We're using this Symphony Beauty Coconut micellar water, and it just like cleans anything that's off my face. And rub it on my face. It smells so good. It doesn't taste good, so don't put it in your mouth. After that, I put on a serum, and right now I'm using this one by Jean Seo, and it's just like a hydrating, like also kind of like a toner. I have super uber dry skin, so I use a lot of hydrating things. I really like this serum. The only thing I don't like about it is it smells like straight up honey. And I hate the smell of just pure honey. Like, I think it's disgusting. But that's kind of no bueno, but it works like a freaking miracle. Okay, and then after that, I just put on a little bit of moisturizer. And I've been using this Aveeno one. It's not technically for, like, specifically for face, but I'm obsessed with it. And it's, like, really light on the skin. It's really freaking good. Lot of hydration. Now I primer. I have two different primers I use. These are both of the ones. One of them is more mattifying and the other one actually fills in my pores. So I think I'm just gonna use the mattifying one. Just so we're not an oily sister. I focus it mostly on my T-zone. I do foundation slash concealer slash BB cream slash whatever I have. Foundation I've been using right now is the Tarte Amazonian Clay one. It's really thick and like really full coverage. I just put that on my fingers. I just rub it in like a lotion, which is probably not very good for my skin. It works, okay? I like blending concealer and foundation in with my fingers because I feel like with sponges or brushes that they like absorb more of the product. And with my fingers, like, it doesn't absorb it, it just pats it into the skin. Now I do some concealer, and I use the Makeup Forever Ultra HD. It's actually supposed to be a foundation, but I find it a lot more creamy and like, I don't know, I think it works good as a concealer. So I just put tiny dabs of that under my eyes. Blend it in. So it looks like I actually sleep, even though I don't. And then I also put a little bit of this around my nose areas right here because I've been having some crazy breakouts right there. Also, I'm having huge breakouts on the side of my face. Like, do you see that? That's so gross. I mean, breakouts are normal. Like, I'm a teenager. I get acne, but I hate it. I set this all with a powder. And I kind of have, like, three different ones I use. It just depends on the day. I really like the Tarte Smooth Operator Amazonian Clay finishing powder. The one I have right now is pretty much gone. Oh my gosh, this is not even coming out. Come on, sister. Sister, stop it. Sister, shazip it. Okay, well, it's barely anything. Fluffy brush. Pack that on. It's like barely any. The Rimmel Blend In Stay Matte Powder. It's like literally completely gone, but it's not a loose powder, so I kind of have to like stick my brush in a lot, like rub it around to actually get the product to come off. That's kind of annoying. All right, next I do contouring and bronzer. Actually, I don't know if this is really contouring or bronzing. It's like both. This is the Maybelline Fit Me. It's supposed to be a setting powder. It's really warm tone, which I like for a bronzer. I like to make it seem like I go outside, because I don't. So I just take that on an angled brush and put it right in the hollows of my cheeks side. Okay, and then I also take that and put it on like my temple. I don't really know why I do this, but I think it looks good. And then I take a really, really light hand of this, put it on my jawline, so it makes it look like I actually have a jawline. And then I do nose contour. I'm gonna use the Bahama Mama. And I just take a skinny, like fluffy blending brush. I like my nose to look really like perky and like a little button nose. So that's like the illusion I wanna try and give. And then we do the sides to make it a little skinnier. And then I do like a little line like right here. So I have like this natural line in my nose. I don't know where it came from, but I just kind of go over that, make it a little more enhanced. There we go, hold on. I don't have my glasses on, so I literally like cannot see. Also, my phone's falling. That's so annoying. I need to tell you guys how ratchet this setup is. So I have my phone taped up on my mirror in my bathroom. And I taped it with sports tape because that's the only tape I could find. So, if it just starts casually like tilting or falling, that would be why. It's because I'm a horrible YouTuber and I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, this contour looks so bad. Okay, next is blush. I am freaking obsessed with blush. I probably put way too much on. First, I put on this color that kind of like blends together my contour and my blush, so like it kind of just mushes all together. I use the Tarte Amazonian Clay 12-hour blush, and this is the color Feisty. It's just like a little peachy thingy McJig. I put it on my nose as well. So now I have a little color. I'm obsessed with like bright pink blush lately. I'm not really sure where that came from, but I got this blush from the dollar store. I know I'm cheap, but it's fine. And it's just like super uber pink, and it's not sparkly at all, which is another thing I love. Like I hate sparkly blush, because I want the only thing to be sparkly is my highlight. Like I don't like the look of glittery blush. So I put like barely any of this on, because look at how freaking pigmented that is. Like I barely tap it in. Just blend that in. I like it to look like I have like a little natural flush. I've been running. We're going to blend her out a bit. Now we do my favorite part, which is highlight. For highlighter, I'm using this like pink kind of holographic one from Estate. I'm freaking in love with it. I love using like fun highlighters. I don't like sticking to the normal like ivory tone one. I take a tiny blending brush again. Blinding for the gods. Yes, queen. Favorite part of the highlighting process, which is nose highlight. You know, I take a super tiny little brush, and I learned this from James Charles, queen. He does like an exclamation point sort of thing, so a line down the bridge, but you stop at that like halfway point, and then you do just a tiny little dot on the end. I put mine a lot higher up because I want to give that illusion that my nose is like me, like a little elf, little button nose, you know? Oh, brows. I use a dark brown eyeshadow. That's literally all I use to fill in my brows. I just use a spoolie to brush them up, and then a little angled brush to fill them in. And the color I use is this like dark brown one from this. Oh, that looks so ratchet. It's from this matte e.l.f. palette. Really any dark brown eyeshadow color works for me, at least. It just has to be a cool toned dark brown, like almost black. Just follow the natural shape of my brow. I like it to make them just a little bit thicker than they actually are, because I love the thick brow look. See how it's like super uber messy right there? That's fine, because I don't have like a start, like a little sperm head of the brows. So I kind of have to like make one of my own And then when it looks super messy like that, I take that same Ulta brush and use the other side. And this is so gross, nobody judge me. I lick it. That's probably why I'm sick all the time. And then I just take off that excess. That little mark right there is my birthmark. It's not makeup. I hate myself, I'm so white. Why did I just do that? I could just use concealer to clean my brows, but I don't, because I don't know what I'm doing. I used to use eyebrow gel to like set these in place, but I ran out of it and I'm too lazy to go buy more. So I started just using the spoolie from the eyebrow gel thing. It was like this e.l.f. eyebrow duo. I put hairspray on it and it works so good. So I just put a few spoolies onto this little spoolie dooly and brush the brows where we want them to go. I like brushing mine up so they look a little bushier and thicker. I honestly don't really care if my brows look a little messy because they're pretty much all the way covered up by my bangs anyway. I just realized I didn't do highlight on my inner corner or my brow bone. We gotta do that. Monolana, get with it. I love inner corner highlight. I've actually scratched my eyes a lot of times because I use not extremely good quality brushes and I basically am sticking them in my eyeball and the bristles are really sharp. We like having that little glow. Now I do my eyes. There's kind of like three different looks I rotate between. I do a really natural like nude eyeshadow look and then just mascara. I do no eyeshadow and I use this brown gold eyeliner thing, or I do just a simple cat eye with a liquid liner. Kind of depends on the vibe I want to go for that day. I'm gonna do the gold liner. What I do is I just take it and put it in the waterline and then I do a normal like cat eye thing with it. I kind of look like a raccoon when I do it. It's fine. If you want to be a raccoon, then be a raccoon. Okay, so we have the underliner done. You probably can't even, well, you can kind of tell. And then I just do a line across the top of my eye and I go all the way into the corner. And then I do a tiny little wing. It looks so bad. Oh my gosh. Why does this always happen? Whenever I like try to make a video, my makeup always looks so freaking bad. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. It's just what we're known for here on this channel. Looking not cute. Whatever. Whatever. Okay. Then lastly, mascara. Ha 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 ha. LOL. Laugh out loud. Do you want to hear the funniest thing? That's a rhetorical question you can't answer because you're a camera. So I was taking a dance class a few weeks ago. And the teacher would say, like, instead of laughing at her joke, she would say LOL. Like, she would just literally, like, say the letters. Like, she was telling us a funny story or something. I don't even know what she was talking about. And then she was like, LOL. Who does that? Literally, who does that? No one. I was cringing so hard. That's the end of my story time. For mascara, I use two different ones. I use the Maybelline Great Lash. And then I use this Mary Kay Lash Intensity. I put it on both sides of my lashes. It's like the back and the front. Just to kind of get more coverage. I also love putting mascara on my bottom lashes. Gotta make that iconic mascara face. Which also makes you look like Miranda Sings. And now I do another coat. Oh, freaking A. Oh, I just got it on. Eyelid. The problem with having long lashes is my bottom lashes literally touch like my under eyes, and so I get all these little black dots right there. Last is the Mary Kay one. Do you ever get like itches in like the back of your throat? Like your soft palate is so itchy, you know? I don't like that. I don't like that. That's annoying. That's really annoying. And then I use the lightest hand when applying this mascara because it's so clumpy. It can make you look cray cray in like 0.5 seconds. But like, look at that. Look at how much longer it made this side than this side. And then you can see on my eyelids. Do you see that mess? Do you see all the stuff on my eyelids? Another reason why I don't use waterproof mascara is because I mess up every 5 seconds and then it's harder to just clean up. And also, if I'm crying in public or at school, I want people to give me attention when they see the mascara running down my face. See that little tiny dude? Where are all your friends, huh? That's a bit sad. So that is it for the makeup. I was gonna do, like, curl my hair for you guys, make that part of this video, but I'm feeling really lazy right now and not wanting to do that. So I'm sure most of you don't care about how I curl my hair. Most of you probably don't care about how I do my makeup either, but alas, Lana doesn't care. Well, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed watching me put crap on my face. You guys, I got this piercing a little bit ago, and it hurts like frickety-frack, but it looks super cool. Tell me your opinion. What do you think? What does it look like? Does it look cute? Does it look ugly? Do I look like I'm trying to be cool, even though I'm really not cool? Let me know. Thanks for watching. Bye!